Yeah.
And don't they live in the sea?
I think so.
Yeah,
Because
and don't they
I'm
call people to their death? Don't they call sailors to their deaths?
Well, yeah, because I think the sirens and water fairies are one and the same. They're just called different things by different cultures.
Yeah.
Whereas I think the banshees are more in the same class as, was it poltergeists? I think.
Yeah, the banshee. Well, in our in Celtic mythology, the banshee signaled a death, and you never went near one, but they follow families and they signal. If you hear one, they signal a death, an upcoming death, and it's not that they're going to do you harm. It's just that it's coming. You know, there's a death in your family coming.
And so now, what's the, I mean, I hate to sound, horrible about it, but what's the point? I mean, like, I mean,
Yeah.
why are they warning you? You know
Yeah.
what I
Are they
mean?
there to frighten you? Yeah. You know what? It's just, I suppose, the fear of people, especially when there was nothing else to believe in. They just believed in all that, and these fairy folk were something they talked about and believed in. And you see, you have to be afraid of something, don't you? You've got to have some stick to pe beat people with, and that's what was used.
Right. I see. Okay, I
Was it
understand.
also, was it kind of used, do you think, as a way of controlling children?
Or brother-in-laws?
Well, your brother-in-laws, yeah. Not the banshee. The banshee wouldn't have been used like the bogeyman would have. The banshee, no, they really believed in the banshee.
I've heard a lot of stories of people that actually have seen a banshee
Yeah,
and
and you're never supposed to approach one, and you're never supposed to speak to one. They can hurt you.
yeah,
And
what
that's
happens to
why in
you?
Ireland you'll never pick up a comb or use a comb, because very often the banshee was seen combing her hair. And if you find a comb, it could be her comb, so you just don't touch it.
What would happen to you if you were to speak to a banshee?
Well, there's one story down around here where I'm from where some man approached the banshee, and she turned on him, and she gave him a hunched back, so he was doubled over almost after speaking to her.
That's what I've heard. Yeah, that's probably what happened to Igor.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's why he's a
Poor
hunchback.
Igor.
Yeah,
Yeah.
you shouldn't talk to the banshee, Igor. Dum
Now,
dum.
too late.
Too late. Boy, well, he's gonna be mad now. Stupid, stinky little
So bad.
hunchback.
So a banshee doesn't actually talk your ear off, then?
Banshee doesn't talk to who?
Does it wail?
Oh yes, it does wail.
Oh yeah, screams like a terrible screeching
Like a
Wailing
banshee.
death.
Does it wail your ear off?
It does. The oven does.
Oh
It's
yeah,
supposed to
like
make you
that.
deaf, right?
Yeah, it does you harm, but only if you approach it.
We have a caller. You're on the air on Monster Castle. Who we got here?
Oh my God, it's Fran.
How you doing, Fran?
Hi,
Good.
Fran.
I'm good. How are you guys?
Awesome. Thanks for calling.
Well, somebody in the chat room, oh, what's his name? Garen, kept
Uh-oh.
saying, call in if you're drunk.
Right
Oh,
on.
that's the rule tonight. We have a 2-drink minimum. Have you
Oh,
abided
I can
by the
still
rules?
drive, though.
Way beyond that.
Me too.
I can still drive, though.
Yeah, right.
I can
Yeah,
drive.
about 5 vodkas and a shot of Jamie
Right on.
for
St.
Welcome
Patrick's
to the
Day.
show.
I had to do it
Welcome
You're
to the
qualified.
show. You are welcome here.
What's got two thumbs and is getting topless pictures of Fran tonight? This guy.
Oh, I can't hear you. I'm
You
getting
can't
really
hear me.
loud, weird noises on your end.
Oh,
You
that
can
was
play.
just cheers, a drop I did. It should be
Oh,
gone now.
there it is.
Sorry about that.
That's
Do you
okay.
got a question for Ellen?
No.
That's
No,
okay.
Fran,
you
call. Fran just calls in,
Hey,
man. She just calls in and does what she
that's
wants.
groovy. I called in drunk, so
That's great.
that's my
That's all you
question.
have to do.
No, Ellen, what what is the deal about the difference between Irish and Scots-Irish? Is
good
it a
question.
Huge deal? I mean, Irish, most people say, oh, you all are Catholic, whereas Scots-Irish are Protestant normally, which is what I am. So I always wear orange and I wear green, both, just to cover my bases on St. Paddy's Day.
Yeah, well, you're right,
so
because the people in
difference?
Scotland are now Protestants because they're in the UK. So there are Catholics over there as well. A lot of people went over from the north of Ireland and they emigrated to Scotland where they made their home. So they have integrated and a lot of them are now Protestant, but a lot of them are still Catholic as well. And then the Irish are Catholics.
Oh, okay.
What do you like better, Ellen?
What do I was?
Or Catholics?
Whoa. Here we go, Darren. Come on.
That's a good question.
She's going to have the IRA
subject,
after her.
Maybe. Fortunately, being an atheist, I'm not either way. And I don't know what Ellen would think about that.
I don't. Do you know what? You're entitled to your beliefs and opinions. I didn't hear what Darren asked me.
Same question. Do you like the Protestants or the Catholics?
Oh, do I like them?
Or the atheists?
I like everybody.
Okay. Yeah,
I have
see,
no
Fran?
Prejudice.
Yeah, she likes everybody, just like me. I like all y'all's.
And I like people. I like people who go to GordonRoop.com and buy my novels.
Yes.
I bet you do.
I like.
Fran, do you listen to our show a lot?
Wait.
I like
to
drunk callers.
Am I speaking?
Oh, that's Darren.
This is Gordon.
And Gordon.
This is Gordon.
And this is Darren.
Damn it, Gordon.
Damn it, Fran.
I'm Adam.
And Adam's here, too. You got five people here.
What?
There is
you
actually
have five people you're
and
talking
you have the,
to.
You have the Wolfman, you have Darren, you have Gordon, you have Ellen, and you have Adam. And we have Fran.
Okay. I don't know all y'all's, but I know Gordon, and he's a troublemaker.
Okay, just ignore him then, and talk to us.
No, he's my favorite.
I know. I want you to.
She likes the troublemakers.
I want you to pick on Gordon.
Of course I do. Why would
Fran
I call
in
drunk
together.
If Gordon wasn't there?
Aw.
You guys used to work together?
Aww.
Yeah, well, it was her job to lure the children into the van.
Oh my god, this is going where I don't want it to go.
Oh, come on, that was funny. You didn't think of it, damn it.
It's a very old joke, Ellen.
Okay.
Yeah, but it's only one I use with
Fran. We played this game months ago with Jimmy, so it's all good. It's all fun and games until your eyes get poked out.
Oh,
but,
yeah. Yeah, it's all fun and games until somebody comes up behind you and bombs you. Yeah.
There's nothing more fun than kidnapping children in a van.
Right.
Well, I mean, I was just
there's
saying,
nothing
you know.
More to this
and
story.
Having me to help you. Right.
Fran, do you listen to our show all the time?
What's that?
Do you listen to our show all the time?
Who, me?
I think this is the first night I've actually tuned in.
Oh, are you the same Fran that's over in Spaced Out Radio?
Yeah, she's in the chat room on lots of shows.
Yeah, I've seen her before. Well, thanks for listening.
Yeah. I'm the one and only old Fran, the old hippie.
Oh, you are Fran. Not old. I keep telling you, you're not old. I'm older than you.
Are you older than me?
You're old Fran.
Yeah.
Oh, whatever. You're vintage.
Classic.
Like a fine wine.
Exactly.
Right. When did you become old? 70? I think 70 is old. Are you 70?
Like an aged Irish whiskey.
Well, then you're
not
old. You're not really old.
Okay,
then.
Fine. Okay. I'm only 63.
Oh, you're young.
I don't care about my age. I just, everybody else seems to, so I just go, I'm old. No big deal. I'm over it.
You're not much older than us.
What was that?
Okay, well, happy St. Patty's Day to y'all.
All right. Wait, thanks for calling.
No, it's not.
Pleased to meet you.
Thanks for being on. Call in, everybody.
Hey.
All right.
Just call in to say what you've been drinking, and that's good enough. We need some callers. Yeah.
You can hang out with us, Fran. You don't have to hang out.
If you want drunk callers, somebody else needs to call in.
Okay.
All right.
I think
you already set a record for most calls in a show anyway, so that's good.
Okay, cool. I'll talk to you all later.
Oh, by the way.
Thank you, Ellen, for answering my question.
Thank you, Fran.
Oh, by the
Thank
way,
you.
Eric says that 69 is fine for him.
I'm not there yet. And I won't get there either.
Yeah, she's not that drunk, guys.
Spank
Come
him on chat.
Yeah, you go
That's
spank him.
You gonna skip that
I
age?
Will have to.
There you go.
Yeah.
Hmm? Yeah, I'm gonna skip that age. It's like that's a done old thing.
That's like Wolfman. Nope. He was like 47 for 5 years.
I'm still 47.
Yep.
Jack Benny was 39
I quit
for
after,
30 years.
Yeah.
So
holy crap! I remember my mom claiming 27 for about 6 years, and I was a little kid, and I figured that out. So, Mike, I don't think it's gonna fly.
A lot of women hang out at 29 for a long time.
Oh, I never did.
Well,
I immediately jumped from 28 to 30. I said, fuck. Oh, excuse me. Sorry.
The first F-bomb of the show goes
29.
To...
That's over.
Fran has scored the first F-bomb in the show. Congratulations.
Oh,
I deserve
you.
A,
so honored.
Thank you for sharing. Actually, that's not true, because we had Fuck You, I'm Drunk as
good.
Songs.
Good.
Flogging Molly got that one.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Oh, man.
Yeah, you guys need to go listen to some Young Dubliners.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah. Young Dubliners.
Yeah. Those guys are cool.
I'm trying to...
They're all here in the States, but they are awesome musicians.
I finally got to
see him live about 6 years ago. Oh my God, what a party. They are cool.
All right.
Anyway,
so, Fran, do they model themselves on the old Dubliners? Is it a band?
Yes. Young Dubliners.
I've heard of them.
Oh, you have?
I haven't.
I have, yeah.
A lot of people know who they are, but they are very cool. They've been around a long time.
So they're not so young anymore?
No, they're not.
They might be in their 69s?
It's the name of the band.
All right.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, they sing. I'm just looking them up here. They sing all the old things like the Foggy Jew, McAlpine's Fusiliers, Rocky Road to Dublin.
Yeah,
all the
Rocky
old
Road,
ones. Yeah,
you betcha.
They nice.
Do that. I posted a link to one of their songs. It's Foggy Dew, which is a beautiful song.
Yeah.
All right. Maybe I'll pick something from theirs for the next break, which is coming up.
Okay, that would be awesome.
All right. I'm trying to add Joe Roop back in because he feels like we. We lost his call there.
Joe's there, too?
Yeah, Joe Roop's in the chat room. And
Is that our stupid producer?
He's not stupid.
I'm joking. That's what Willie says.
He was on with Willie there a minute ago.
Yeah, I thought so.
Who do we got here? I'm trying to add
him
back in.
Will you stay if we bring Joe back, Fran?
Go ahead.
I tried to add him back.
Drop my ass and get Joe in.
No, we can. You should be able to add both of you. Joe is good.
Really? Okay.
Well, I tried to add him in. He's going to have to call. He's not picking up.
Let me add him. I'll add him. See what happens here.
See, Ellen is going to have such a horrible impression of Americans. She's
no,
never going to.
No, I'm not. No, I love
she
America.
She should.
I've been over there lots
she
of times.
She should. Americans are crass people.
No, you're
sorry,
not.
But it's true.
What do you think?
We're lovable in a weird way.
What do you think of Canadians, Ellen?
You know, the first Canadian I spoke to was you, so I don't know, but I'm forming an impression, and I think I like them too.
Oh, that's all right.
Thank you.
And
I love Canadians, and I love everyone.
We're tasty.
I work at a visitor center here in Arizona, and we get people from all over the world coming in, and all of them are just awesome people. They're here to experience Arizona, and it's incredible.
I was just down there. I loved it.
You know,
where were you?
We're picking.
Well, I went to the.
Oh, go ahead.
I went to the UFO Congress in Phoenix, and then I went to Tucson and had some really good Mexican food.
Okay, you went south.
What is that mountain that's in between there? Pick a something. There's a mountain between Tucson and Phoenix.
Oh. Oof.
I want to climb that.
You got me on that one. Pikachu.
Oh, I figured. Yeah, it's something like that. It's not Pikachu, but it's something like that.
Yeah.
That was beautiful. And Squaw Peak, Camelback
Mountain. I'm in central Arizona, so most of the stuff I know is up here. But I used to live in Phoenix way back in the day.
So you're a little north of Phoenix?
Yeah, about 60, 70 miles north.
Do you know where Skull Valley is?
Yeah.
Yeah, I have relatives that are from there.
Wow.
In Prescott. Yeah,
that's
they were
kind of a obscure place, Skull Valley.
Okay, now you can now you can say hi to Joe. Joe should be there now. How
what?
You doing? Joe?
I don't know if my audio is working or not. There's a lot of people.
Oh, yeah, we can hear you.
You sound great.
Yeah. Talk.
Joe, you there?
Yeah, I've been drinking Dr. Pepper.
No, you better have something in there.
You like
blast them off the air. Blast them off of here.
Oh, no.
You're not abiding by the rules.
How do you know what he has?
I can't drink, dude. I'll be in the hospital. Like, my organs have given up on me.
Oh, no.
Oh, okay. Well, we'll forgive you then.
Yeah, okay. Since we're picking on Fran,
Dr. Pepper
though, I want to say
Fran. Dr. Pepper isn't going to help either. Sorry.
Oh, no. Fran posted a picture earlier this week on Facebook of her from about, what was it, 20 years ago, you said?
I saw it, yeah. She's a cutie.
45 years ago, almost.
What a naughty girl. You need a spanking.
Bell-bottom cutie.
I know it, right? She was rocking them disco pants, brother.
I had on my cowboy boots, at least, in that picture. I was looking at it going, was I wearing my boots or my moccasins? And I went, those are my boots. Yeah, that's an oldie but a goodie.
And and you had those are your dancing boots? Did you do what kind of dancing?
Oh no, those were my shit kicking.
Oh, shit kicking boots. All right,
yeah,
shit kickers.
Yeah, anybody messed with me, they got my cowboy boots in their shins.
Oh man, feisty.
Yeah,
she's feisty.
I looked like a sweet girl, but yeah,
poor Ellen,
not so much.
No, that's what I was saying. She's never going to want to come to America ever.
Poor Ellen.
I love America. Why am I poor?
I don't know. I didn't say you were poor. I just feel like we're leaving you out.
Ellen, have you been to America before?
I'm enjoying this.
But have you actually ever come to America?
I've been in America about 6 times.
Okay. East Coast, West Coast.
East. New York East. And where's beside New York? New Jersey.
Oh, God. You went to New Jersey? I'm sorry.
Yeah, my brother lives in New Jersey.
The west side of the states is entirely different.
Completely.
We have a whole different thing going on out here.
Yeah.
Come to the south. Come down here to the Ozarks.
So next time you come to the States, you need to hit the West Coast.
Okay.
Or at least the Southwest.
I'd love to see California. I'd love to go to, you know where those giant redwoods are?
Oregon.
The park? Oh, yeah. The Sequoias up north, Northern California. You bet.
Yeah, I'd love to go there.
And,
it's beautiful.
You can drive,
I've been there.
You can drive through a tree. I can still drive, by the way. I can still drive. I'm good to go.
Yeah.
There's somebody hid my keys, so and I'll be all right. Where's my keys?
The John Muir Woods.
Yeah.
They chopped that tree down,
it's
didn't they?
Absolutely gorgeous.
That tree that you could drive through, I heard they just took it down.
Yeah.
Ooh.
No, it didn't get taken down except by the storm.
Oh, that's
it
right.
Collapsed.
A storm. A storm got it.
Oh.
It broke.
So what age was that tree?
Probably. Who the hell knows? It's hard to tell.
Because there's a slice of one of those giant redwood trees in the Natural History Museum in New York on Central Park, and it's massive. It's as wide and as tall as my house.
Wait a minute.
Wow.
Where's Darren?
It wasn't my turn to watch him.
He's gone.
I've been there. They're amazing.
There he is.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's where Bigfoot is. Northern California.
Is it?
And you know what? There's redwoods in Oregon, too.
Out up there.
There's redwoods in Oregon. People don't know that, but along the coast there are.
Oh, yeah.
There's small stands of them. There's one by Tillamook that's just incredible.
Ellen, do they have anything like Bigfoot in Ireland?
No, the closest thing I can think of is the Loch Ness Monster in Scotland. But we had giants in Ireland. They made the Giant's Causeway because they were in a big fight, the giant from the north of Ireland and the giant from Scotland. And they had a big fight and they formed the Giant's Causeway. That's as good, isn't it?
Oh, yes. And I heard about that. Like, they live in the colder regions in the mountains. The giants, isn't that where they
do they?
I don't know. I heard they live up in the mountains or something in the cold area.
Yeah, maybe they do. We don't have any mountains in Ireland. We only have hills.
Okay.
I think they have mountainy places in Scotland.
Maybe that's where
but
I heard.
The Giant's Causeway is, it's fantastic. It's, you've never seen anything like it. It's columns of octagonal shapes, and it was formed because these giants were fighting, and really there was some sort of earthquake or movement, and it formed this rock, which is it is spectacular. That's somewhere you'll have to come.
Do you get sunlight there at all? It doesn't look like you guys get any sunlight.
Why?
Well, I'm looking at your website. It's a really nice website, by the way, but there's no sunlight anywhere.
No. Yeah. Okay, I must look at it for that. Maybe I should take a few photographs on a sunny day.
That would be nice.
Makes me think there's no sun.
No, didn't you guys watch The Highlander on TV? There were sunny days in Scotland. And in Ireland.
One or two.
it rains a lot.
Yeah, remember a few of them.
The Beatles lyric, you get a tan from standing in the Irish rain.
Did they?
Oh, my God.
Yeah, from...
What song?
I'm the Walrus.
Oh. I didn't know that.
I'm going to have to look up the lyrics
Are you sure you're not making that up?
I'll look it up right now. I'm looking up
to Google.
I'm going to Google.
Now, I used to sing that song. I don't remember those lyrics at all.
I don't either. I think he's full.
What in the hell were you playing during break? I was coming back from the store and I thought I'd turn it to the pop hits or something. It sounded like Britney Spears was singing.
Oh,
what was that?
That was a.
Oh, no.
Oh, what are they called now? I forget. It was C'est la vie, and I just tried it out. It's supposed to be one of the most popular Irish drinking music for St. Paddy's Day, but
really?
I can't remember what they're called now.
It wasn't Siobhan.
Hmm.
Okay, I found the lyrics, guys.
I'll find it.
I'm the Walrus.
Yeah, I am the Walrus. It's sitting in an English garden waiting for the sun. If the sun don't come, you get a tan from standing in the English rain.
Oh, okay.
Well, oh, that's right, too. Yeah. English rain, yeah.
Hey, and I'm going to hang up now.
The band was
so
called...
somebody else can call in, okay?
Well, anyone can call in now.
Right. Yeah, they can still call
in. You're just an extra person.
Oh,
anyway,
yeah,
just I can join add them. In.
Yeah, I can
not,
join someone
yeah, you're
in.
You're not stopping anybody.
Yeah, I've got two lines, so okay, there's lots of room.
Somebody, hey, Eric, call.
Yeah,
you're
okay.
You're giving me crap
drunk
over here in chat.
Drunk Eric, call.
Yeah, he's getting flirty with you there.
We need drunk callers.
By the way, that band...
Oh, my God. He's giving me hugs and kisses.
Yeah, by that band... The band was called Bewitched.
I don't know this man. Barely.
You don't know Eric the Protector? He's a
no.
legend.
I don't know who...
Well,
you
know who
Eric
he
is
in chat, but I don't know him personally.
Oh, well, you need to meet him.
A lot
maybe
of
you should hang out.
Fader Knots that I know a lot of them from CITD, but I don't think I know this Eric.
He's a co-host of Quantum
Hologram.
What's the show
Matrix.
Called? Quantum Matrix?
Quantum Hologram.
Quantum Hologram
Matrix.
Or other.
Yeah, with the Reverend John Polk.
Yeah.
So how many Erics
Reverend
are there, though? Because I think there's like three, isn't there?
Three what?
Three?
Yeah, Eric the Protector, the Awakening Man. I get him confused with
Ophidian.
Ophidian.
Yeah, he's got three names. On our show, he's called Eric the Protector,
Ophidian,
but he doesn't like that. He likes Ophidian.
It
all depends.
The Eric that I met was the one at CITD last year that had another house that I cooked trout at.
Maybe that was the same guy.
Gigi's running around with this huge, huge package of trout going, who knows how to do this? And I'm like, I do.
Oh, God.
I had to cook the trout and fix it and debone it afterwards. And no pictures were taken. We had tons of pictures of bacon from Cortana. No trout pictures from me. I am so...
What's so special about bacon?
Dissed by that. Afterwards. No
bacon. It smells like fish, tastes like fish, but it fries up like bacon. All right. Eric.
No.
Eric, are you there?
That's a different Eric. That's the rich real estate Eric from L.A. Yeah.
Who? Which one?
Eric,
I didn't go last year, but I'm going this year.
Are you okay? Then I get to meet you. I'll be there.
Yeah, I'm the Eric that's on Fade to Black all the time. You see me probably tweeting all the crazy shit all the time.
Yeah,
right.
You took pictures of the Men in Black, didn't you?
I'm the sarcastic guy that's really kind of out there and bold, but I tell the truth though.
And you also have a
Mr.
Twitter
sarcasm.
You also have a Twitter profile.
I tweet all the pictures. I am the guy that tweets
it's
all
the
pictures.
Awakening Man, I think.
He's 6 foot four. You'll spot him in a heartbeat.
Yeah, we're going to have a good time with CITD.
I'm just going to have to go up and poke you guys and go, who are you? Who are you? Are you Eric?
I'll be at the Monet room.
What's wrong with that old lady?
The Monet room?
To which...
They have this complex there. It's called, they call it the Fader compound, and it's called the Starlight Villas, the Fader House. But I learned this just recently. There's the Starlight Villas, which last year the Fader House, which is where the party was happening, is one of six other little houses right there in that little community. So I just I reserved the Monet Fader House. It's like a little one-bedroom house with a living room and a kitchen and a king-size bed and a jacuzzi. So, anyway, I'm looking forward to that.
Okay, well, from what I hear, and this is old news, I think, is that Dan Zukowski reserved a couple of houses.
Yes, he did.
So we're going to have three in the same complex?
We're going to have four. We're going to have four or five. I think we might have all seven of them, I think. Probably Jimmy and a few other people reserve the other one. But, yeah, the whole Fader clan will be there. We're going to have iced Rivermoon coffee with vodka and Bailey's cream. Wolf, is there any way you could get out there in...
I don't know. I would have to cross a border, and I'm not sure if they'll let me cross that border. I don't know.
He's got warrants.
Darren, what about you, Darren? You going to go?
They look at me and my hairy face and my fangs and stuff, and they think I'm weird, you know, and they probably want to put me in a cage or something. I don't know if I'm going to try doing that. I don't know.
No, we'll set you
Come
loose.
On, tell the truth, dude. You got warrants.
I got one warrant.
If you're in the U.S., Wolf, they would 5150 your ass.
Anyways, guys, we're going to take a quick break, and then we're coming back. We're getting the last 15 minutes, so we're going to come up with some questions for Ellen to finish the show. We will be right back on Monster Castle Paranormal. All right. Dig this.
Come on.
And fare thee well to Ireland, the land of my native home. Breaks my heart far to see friends part, and then the teardrops fall. More. I'm leaving behind the one I love, Paddy's Green Shamrock Shore. The ship she lies. Shine down each night as we sail out over the sea. Many ships have been lost, many lives have cost on the journey that lies before. With a tear in my eye, I'm bidding goodbye to Paddy's Green Shamrock Shore. Took one last glance.
daddy's green shamrock shore. And I took a chance, took one last glance at Paddy's green shamrock shore.
Well, Monster Castle, paranormal. All right, we are back. And does anybody have any last questions for Ellen? We have 10 minutes in the show here. I love that song. Was great, by the way. Ellen, thanks for the request.
Do you know any? Or go let Adam ask first because he hadn't really asked anything in a while.
Yeah, let Adam talk. Is Adam there?
What is your? Your most favorite constellation that you can see in your part of the world?
What's a constellation? Because a constellation to me is stars in the sky.
Yeah.
That's what you're asking me. Oh, do you know I don't know because I don't know anything about the sky. I'm sorry, Adam.
You're not a stargazer? Ellen?
No.
Not really, eh? Oh, you gotta doing it. You gotta start looking at the sky. There's weird things in the sky. There's wheels in the sky, and they go round. Yeah, they spin round.
I thought that was the wheels on the bus.
It was light. I saw light. Yeah.
What I want to know, I have a question.
And they were spinning.
This is Fran again.
All right.
What does Ireland actually celebrate today or no?
Yes.
Because I've heard conflicting stories.
Today is our national day. Well, yesterday. I'm saying today because So, yeah, we do. Apparently, St. Patrick died on the 17th of March, and that's why it's celebrated on the 17th of March. Because people are always saying, why don't you move St. Patrick's Day to the summer when it's warm? But there's a reason.
Okay. That makes sense. Okay, good. Because I kept hearing conflicting stories, you know, that Americans, the Irish Americans, made such a big deal out of St. Patrick's Day, whereas the Irish really didn't.
I heard that too.
But they do have a big parade there and everything. And is that the day that St. Patrick died, March 17th? Is that when he died?
Yeah.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
Okay.
Apparently, yeah, that's why it's celebrated. That's why it's his day.
If he was married and he killed snakes, do you think he was really a real person, or you think that's just a myth, the whole thing about St. Patrick?
I think there was some great person who came to Ireland and did some things, but you see, it's like any folklore. It's built on and built on, and the story gets bigger and bigger. So he was able to banish snakes, but I only heard he was married yesterday or the day before, so I must look into that and see what I can find.
So then he probably, when he banished all the snakes, I bet you that the Loch Ness Monster had to go too, and that's why that's why we can't find him.
No.
That's why he ended up in Scotland,
tail between his legs.
Bards or druids? I'm friends with a pretty high-ranking druid over there in Ireland right now.
Are you? No, I don't. I only know where there's a coven of witches.
We should have him on one time, Joe.
He's supposed to come on my show, but I can get him on your. I don't know why he hasn't showed up, but his name's Sean. He's a really good guy, and he's been he's like a 32nd degree Mason.
Wow,
super high level druid too as well.
Sounds like.
By the way, the elementals, there are real elementals. They're called the gnomes, the undines, and the salamanders, and I forget the other one.
I didn't know that gnomes were an elemental.
Yeah, they're earth elementals.
Wow. Well, I guess that makes sense, Well, we're getting near the end of the show, guys. So if anybody wants, like, Gordon, you want to advertise your books a little bit?
Well, Pretty much everybody knows my deal. Conspiracy kind of books, history books, all at GordonRoop.com. All my interviews, all my everything's there.
Ooh.
That's well, check that out, Gordon. Yeah. Sounds great.
Yeah.
Well, thank you, Ellen. I enjoyed talking to you very much. I hope to talk to you again in the future.
And likewise. Very good. Thank you.
Oh, right on. So there, you got some feedback from your book there, too. Fran digs it.
Fran digs what book?
Hey, Wolfman.
Oh, hi, Kurt.
Hey, how you doing? I'm sorry you got in here late.
Yeah, that's okay. Can you stick around for the next show? We're going to be back with Dirty Rotten Taro. But I don't think we're going to put this time on the network, are we, Joe?
It's on. It'll be on Spreaker.
It'll be on Spreaker, yeah. So if you're listening on The Fringe FM, KTOK,
you're gonna get reruns.
Yeah, you'll get, but yeah, because
hey, Joe,
we're just too vulgar for on our next show. It's crazy. So, but if you want to hear the craziness, then you could listen over on Spreaker and just look for Dirty Rotten Taro, which will be starting about 15 minutes or half hour after this show.
No,
as soon as I get the title
right
posted. As soon as I can get her started, put it that way.
You got me, Kurt, Darren, and whoever else. We'll make it happen.
All right. Let me tell you, I have to be at work at 10:30 Arizona time, so I can stay on for like a little while, but I'd be glad to.
All right, on. Okay. And thank you so much. I got to say
10:30 tomorrow morning, Kurt?
Yeah.
Okay, and we got to say thanks,
though. I have to get up at 6 o'clock, so shut up. I don't want to hear it.
Oh, my Lord. How do you do it?
We're having a party tonight, and it ain't no party like a Wolfman party, okay?
What you come do is now. You just get up
ain't
in the
no
morning,
like
and you open
party.
Another beer, and you just drink
castle.
Some old beer, and you're good to go.
Dirty Run. In about 5 minutes, you're going to get Dirty Run.
Oh, yeah.
Dirty Run.
Yeah, and we're going to have some taro readings, and we usually do it in a very humorous fashion, but they are real readings, and I don't know, Joe, if you want to join us, you can help me do some taro, if you want.
Man, I'm probably just going to listen and fall asleep to, that's what I used to do when I first started listening to your show. It's better that way.
All right.
You can bring out those sinister cards. Aleister Crowley.
Okay. We got 3 minutes left. Thanks, Ellen, for coming
on.
Thank you very much. You were amazing, very very entertaining, and beautiful voice, I might add. Can you tell everybody? You can find her actually on Twitter, and that's Mysterious HOLS, right? At
yeah.
Mysterious HOLS.
I need to follow her on Twitter. I didn't even know she was on Twitter.
Yeah,
well, thank you, and I want to thank you again for having me on. I really appreciate it. I enjoyed it. I go on and I try to listen to your podcasts. But Adam, thank you. Mike, thank you. Gordon, Joseph, everybody, and Fran. Everything was really interesting.
I really digged it. She's
from. I missed all that.
Ellen, it was so nice speaking with you.
Yeah, and I love the way that you can talk and tweet. And at the same time, that's pretty wicked. That's pretty. I like it when a guest can tweet and talk at the same time. You don't even realize it, but they're. That's
in
like
real time,
having two voices at the same time.
Can I just say this? Just hearing her voice, it brought back memories of an Irish woman I once loved years ago, and it brought back good memories. So I'm grateful
there
to hear
you
her
are.
Speak to me.
Wolfman, hope your mama okay. I've been praying. Everybody around me been praying. All my followers.
Thank
she
you,
all
buddy.
Right?
Yeah, she's doing much better. She's every
I'm
day.
So
she's every day. She's recovering more. So, it, really well. Actually, the doctors say very quickly recovering. So, I think everybody's prayers and good intentions and light healing energy or whatever you do is working.
Yeah. Yeah.
The combined effort is working. And I really appreciate that. You guys don't know what that means to me. It's like a big family that, you know what I mean? Here and it's pretty cool.
We know you love your mom, dude.
We love you, Wolfman. And your mom.
Oh, so we need to get the Sledge playing. Remember the Sister Sledge saying that song, We Are Family, back in the...
Yeah, but that's not what I usually end the show with, this one.
I got all my brothers and sisters.
Might have been 78.
Yeah, there you go. She nailed it. I saw him open, I saw him at the open call scene where the Raiders played.
They played that in the... Remember the show where Goldie Hawn went to the Army? And
yep.
She
pick
and the blue dye in the face of the curly headed, oh gosh, what was that called? Goldie Hawn Benjamin. In the Army. Her
Private Benjamin.
Private Benjamin.
They were all dancing in the called whatever it's called, and that lady with the stick walked in.
Thanks everybody for listening, eh?
Who did that song though? Was that Sister Sledge?
Yes.
Okay,
Sledge.
Didn't one of them just pass away? The oldest. Yes.
Brian, you can hang with us if you want for the next show too.
Hey, you remember that group, Machique? They said it's all freak out.
Oh yeah.
Machique freak out.
Freak out.